You're watching Fox in the Morning Weekends, your station for balanced news.
Good morning and welcome to Fox in the Morning Weekends. I'm Anita Lightfoot.
And I'm Lynn Stewart.
And Botox for the body, it's just not for your face anymore. We'll tell you how it makes the rest of you look a little younger, at least. That's in theory. We're not convinced of it yet, so we'll see what our guests have to say.
Yeah, we're having a lot of discussions about it this morning. You know, make up your mind and see what you think, but very odd places people are injecting Botox. So
pretty
stay
much
tuned for that.
Everywhere.
Everywhere.
And from your feet to your neck, even your armpits. What
Yikes.
Botox can do for your problem areas.
Ooh.
Ow. Yes. Welcome back to Fox in the Morning Weekends. You can say goodbye to lumpy thighs and a droopy neck now. Botox isn't just for your face anymore, and other fillers are also available to help make you look a little bit younger. Dr. Douglas Keel from La Jolla Spa MD is here with us on why Botox is now being used for almost every part of your body that you can imagine.
Well,
good morning.
It's true. Botox is used almost everywhere now. Some of the places that we love to use it, of course, are the upper face and for the fine lines and wrinkles on the forehead and around the eyes. But now everybody's asking for Botox in other areas to help with wrinkles. So we have figured out some other things in other areas to use it.
You were also saying that there are some other fillers that can help you look younger, for lack of a better word, better. I'm not
yes.
sure. I hate to say those
yes.
things because it's not a bad thing to age.
Yes.
But let's take a look at the thighs. You
yes.
were saying that there's some fillers that you can use to help kind of smooth out.
Yes. Well, unfortunately, a lot of patients come to us after having liposuction, and they have either a defect or a fat divot in the skin, and they'll come in and say, "Hey, how can you fix this?" And you know, before what we used to do is just inject fat. We would take fat from another area of the body and inject it to smooth that area out. There's now a product called Sculptra, which actually works very well for that area as well as the fat. So we have a combination of things to kind of help with that. And you might see the before and after photographs. There, you know, the fat atrophy on the outer thighs. It's very common if a patient isn't positioned properly during liposuction.
Mm-hmm.
And usually, it's under general anesthesia. So what we try to do is fix that and make it as smooth as possible.
How long does that last? Is it something that you do have to replace over time?
Well, Sculptra probably lasts about 2 years, and so and then it slowly degrades after that. So it's probably at least 2 years.
So longer than what your actual body fat would.
Right, right, exactly.
All right, now this is a new one on me.
Yeah.
You can use Botox for your neck. Tell us
yes.
why you would do that and what the effect is.
You know, this is phenomenal. Botox works in a muscle called the platysmal muscle, and it's a muscle that kind of it drapes on your neck. When the muscle tightens, it causes the vertical banding that happens on the neck. And again, we have some before and after photos.
It's really dramatic.
Yeah, it is. It
wow.
is. Just a few drops of Botox into the vertical bands, and you know, these muscles relax and the skin softens and settles down.
Man, that really just changes the way you look from like 10 years. That takes easily 10 years off.
The thing is, you know, this is kind of a different use for Botox. So this really needs to be done by somebody with a lot of experience using Botox. There can be some side effects if you don't do this properly, such as, you know, problems with the throat and swallowing and even breathing. So, you know, again, this has to be done by somebody that has a lot of Botox.
That was my biggest concern, because you hear about so many of these Botox parties, and then
mm-hmm.
it seemed like there were other possible complications as well when
right.
you're dealing with your throat and main
yes.
artery veins
yeah.
and that
and
sort of thing.
And again, you know, experience. It's experience that is going to dictate the outcome of the treatment.
All right, there are so many uses for Botox, but let's get right to the last one, the armpits.
Oh.
Now, why do you use it for your armpits? There's no wrinkles
okay.
there, are there?
No, no wrinkles, but actually Botox works very well for stopping sweating. And so so people with a condition called hyperhidrosis, which is excessive sweating, they use it. Also, just normal people that basically want to stop some underarm sweating, it can really help. It also works in the palms and soles of the feet, so palms and the feet. And, you know, if you don't want to approach somebody with a sweaty, kind of a clammy hand, you know, this really works well for that.
All right. Well, it gives all new meaning to never let them see you sweat.
That's right.
Thanks for being here, Dr.
Right,
Keel.
Thank you.
If you'd like more information, just log on to our website at fox6.com.
Welcome to Inside San Diego, where we take a personal look at the hottest trends under the sun. On today's show, we'll have the most San Diego has to offer in love, life, fashion, fitness, food, and all-around entertainment. Live from the studios at KUSI News, Inside San Diego.
Plus, Botox and fillers, they're not just for faces anymore. We'll show you the other areas of the body where injectables are now being used, and I think the neck is one of them.
I think so. Wow.
From reducing cellulite to rejuvenating aging hands, Botox is being brought to a whole new level. Coming up, we'll show you the new ways wrinkle injectables are being used. Welcome back. Many people are familiar with Botox injections to smooth out wrinkles. Well, now injectables are being used for much more, from feet and hands to armpits, all kinds of body parts. Dr. Douglas Keel, a dermatologist from La Jolla Spa MD, is with me this morning to share some of these latest procedures. Welcome.
Well, thanks for having me.
When we talk about injectables, we're talking about not only Botox, which paralyzes the muscles.
Oh, it doesn't paralyze. It settles the muscles.
Settles the muscles.
Right, smooths things.
Smooths things out. But we're also talking about injectables that are fillers, right?
Right. There's a lot of different fillers that we have to smooth areas of the body, mm-hmm. and it's phenomenal. We use a lot of these things in the face and upper face, around the eyes, to smooth the fine lines and wrinkles. It's a natural projection to kind of move them down to the body. So things for the hands, we have things for the legs, we have things for the feet, even under the arms.
Let's show a picture. We have a picture of a before and after of a neck,
right,
which was injected with Botox. And
right.
Tell us what it does.
Well, Botox is wonderful for the neck. Basically, the neck has a muscle called the platysmal muscle, and it's like a drape that sits on the neck. And when the platysmal muscle contracts, what you get is these fine bands in the neck. Just a few drops of Botox in those bands will help to settle the muscle.
Wow.
And really smooth the skin out.
Look at that. They're gone.
Yeah.
They're gone.
It's amazing. And
how long will that last, that effect?
You know, that's probably anywhere from 4 to 6 months,
mm-hmm.
Depending on the amount of Botox that's injected. Now, the big thing about this is this really needs to be done by a professional, somebody that really does a lot of Botox, because this isn't a normal Botox injection. It's not like, treating it up in the upper face. We're treating in the neck, and there's structures that you want to avoid.
Right. What kind of risks are associated with Botox in the neck?
Yeah, against, swallowing. I mean, you have to be able to swallow and use the muscles in your neck. And if you're settling these muscles down, again, you just need experience doing this, knowing where to inject.
Right. Okay. Well, let's look at another one, someplace you might not think of when it comes to an injectable. And
right.
This type of an injection is for a filler to help with cellulite.
Right. Actually, it's funny. This is a product called Sculptra, and this actually isn't a picture of cellulite. This is a picture of a fat defect,
mm-hmm.
after liposuction. And unfortunately, some patients will come to us after they've had liposuction in a facility and they haven't been positioned properly.
And it looks like cellulite is what ends up happening.
Yeah, it does. It's a little divot in the skin.
Mm-hmm.
And so what we can do is actually inject. We used to just take fat. We would take fat out of another area in the body and put it into the defect to kind of smooth things out. But now there's actually other things, and Sculptor works very well there. It's just an injection into the skin deep down, and it smooths the skin.
And that lasts for a couple years?
Yeah, at least 2 years.
That's a long time.
It's great.
Yeah. Okay, we have another one to share,
mm-hmm.
and this is a picture of hands, before and after.
Yes.
And what has happened here?
Okay. Well, the hands, they have natural tendons in the hands, and over time we lose volume in the hands,
mm-hmm.
and so we lose fat and the tissues underneath the skin. So what you can see is the veins kind of stick out, the tendons stick out, and it kind of gives a skeletonized look. So we can inject fillers in that area to really smooth the skin. One of the fillers, again, Sculptra is used in the hands. Also Restylane or Juvederm,
mm-hmm.
hyaluronic acid is used. We also do the fat injections still. And so these are different options that we have, and everybody's different. You know, one person might not want a filler. They might want their own natural fat, and one person might want, something else. So
right.
It's,
also, something that I recently heard of is some people who have problems on the balls of their feet will get fat injected into their feet.
Yeah, well, this is a very interesting thing, and actually, it's been around for a couple years. There are people that inject Restylane or hyaluronic acid into the foot, and again, the foot is like any other structure. The more you walk on it, the more you're going to lose the fat and the sponginess of the foot. So if you put a little pillow of Restylane or hyaluronic acid in there, it can really kind of, cushion the balls of the foot. Women aren't going to give up their high heels, so we have to do something to
help.
That's
right. Those high heels are staying. Dr.
That's
Douglas
right.
Keel from Spa MD. Thanks so much for the tips. We're going to have all of the information on the KUSI website.
Well, great. Thanks for having me.
Appreciate your time this morning.